Hey everybody, welcome to this new season of AdSkills podcast, where we bring you the stories of media buyers, their trials, their tribulations, their triumphs, all of that exposed here in this new season of AdSkills podcast. And we couldn't think of somebody better to kick off this season than Brian Pedder, because let's face it, this year, don't know where you've been, but it's been a little bit different. 2020 has been just a tad different to other years. And Brian's journey with us through AdSkills and through COVID and through using media buyer and using media buying in a pandemic is a story that I think is really going to resonate with a lot of you today. But the very first thing I'd love to ask, because one of the great things about media buying being that one of the most new and interestingly, just released, it's in the top 20 growing professions in the United States now. So how about that? That and yoga instructors. But we're here for the media buying aspect, all right? Because if you've ever seen Justin Brooke do yoga, well, you haven't seen him do yoga, let me tell you. So it's a real honor and a privilege to have Brian Pedder here with us. And of course, Brian, what were you doing before you started doing media buying? Because you have got quite a background in media buying, but what did you train as? What did you start out as?
Yeah, so a long time ago, I've really been in internet marketing since 2010. Prior to that, I was managing resort properties in Colorado, ski properties, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But I went to buy a business, and the business fell through. And there's that old Frank Kern kind of bit where, you know, we all get into internet marketing by buying that first course.
Yes.
So, you know, you buy that first course and then you're hooked, right? So that was a long time ago, 10 years ago now.
Yep.
And, you know, I've spent a lot of time between now and then in the affiliate world and, you know, doing all the sort of stuff that a lot of us get started doing, diet pills and skincare and that sort of thing.
Yes.
And then moved on to work for agencies, just doing Facebook and email and YouTube.
Yeah. Can I ask you a question about that? What do you think managing properties, all right, managing those resort properties in Colorado, how did that help you or prepare you for your career in media buying? Have you been able to pull anything out of those experiences?
You know, it's interesting. The correlation, I never thought about it, but a great question. As it relates to speaking and managing with property owners is very similar to the dealing with and helping business owners with their goals.
Yes.
Because they have similar desires and outcomes, essentially. So they want to make sure that their properties are making money and they're well taken care of and that people treat them nicely. And essentially, it's almost the exact same thing with...
There you go.
With buying ads. So,
yeah, it's always interesting to me to see how our backgrounds relate to media buying, which is really interesting. So how did you find yourself in the AdSkills universe? So could you tell us that story?
Yeah, absolutely. So 2015, I pivoted out of an affiliate business and then just started freelance work with agencies and have been doing that really ever since, just as their hitman, essentially. So, you know, anybody that needed email or long-form copy, which I know be, you know, something that you do, and Facebook ad buying, and I would go in and help them out with that. Worked in all kinds of different realms there. Olympic wrestling was a big one that I helped with for a long time.
Yep.
Teaching people how to wrestle, teaching coaches how to teach wrestling, that sort of thing. Well, that was pretty fun.
Yep.
And it just got to the point where, I mean, we'll talk about this more probably, but the COVID came up and
yes.
I had I specialize in Facebook ads, Shopify and Klaviyo. Essentially, that's kind of my, if I can get you, you know, if I have enough margin and a decent average order value, I could pretty much get you working on those without too much trouble, assuming it's compliant and all that jazz.
Yes.
I had an e-commerce client pivot from their sort of existing product into masks at the beginning of COVID.
Yep.
And you can imagine what happened from there. I ended up helping them make just shy of $10 million, and I didn't particularly get paid any more in a significant way than I would have otherwise.
Yes.
So I went looking for something that I felt like either I could control a bit more, or that would be performance-based in the way that, you know, performance ads are. I came across Justin's posts and his excellent sort of long-form tomes about the inner workings of media buying. And it's almost the exact opposite of what you typically see from, you know, the gurus, if you will. And it really was very interesting to me. And I found his webinar about how to survive COVID, and then the subsequent offer was joining the junior media buyer certification course. I needed, as I mentioned, a change. So I'd already been working as a media buyer for quite a long time, but one of the agencies I worked for had access to, or was a member of Pro League. So I had access to all of those courses. They were all excellent. I was like, all right, well, if I'm going to take a jump, having an extra certification never hurts. I have the Facebook certification. So I added this junior media buyer cert, went through the excellent course there that's very well thought out. For somebody who had never been through media buying, I think it would be an excellent first primer. And then they plop you into a very supportive Slack channel where you can ask, you know, why the sky is blue. And they're like, well, that's not a dumb question. We're happy to tell you all about it. So kudos to that group and to your whole team for that product. It's excellent. And they have, just like the Pro League channel, I think, has a lead channel. And I was able to close an e-commerce client in the first couple of weeks out of that lead channel to quite easily pay for the ticket to get in the course. And that, I think, is why we're talking.
Yeah, that is super fantastic. I love hearing stories like that. One of the things that I picked up on there, and it was, and I'd be interested to explore this transition. You have started to, one of your specialties is, you know, if you're working with somebody with e-commerce and you know what their numbers are, and as you said, it's not in a restricted category, or it's one of those areas, you can make the magic happen there, as you did fortunately and unfortunately with that masks situation, where, you know, media buyers with their skills can make their clients an enormous sum of money. And often, well, the contract's the contract. And if you're being paid per hour or you're being paid a small retainer. So we're really excited. So how did you take that lesson, your e-commerce speciality, and what are you doing now? What have you noticed in e-commerce in particular that you now that you're running your own ship, so to speak, Brian? What are some of the things that you're noticing there?
Well, the clients that I'm most attracted to at this point are essentially the opposite of the mask pivot folks. So I'm really interested in people who have a business that's at least a couple of years old. I don't love the startup hustle because there's a lot of things that people don't understand as it relates to, you know, ads and getting people's attention and understanding who your avatar is and, you know, all the things that Justin talks about, right? But once you find somebody like that, I have been able to, there's a couple of clients that stand out. I have a copper client that sells copper cookware. He's up 200% since last year. And some of that obviously is COVID, right? Like there's some COVID buy-e behavior that's happening. Yeah. I can't really quantify that. And then I've got a chocolate shop in Australia, actually, who had no online business. She had three physical shops, had no online business November of last year. And this year she's on pace to break $500,000 in Shopify.
Wow.
So she's doing 60, 70 grand a month. And a lot of that's with with email. And, you know, one of the things that's so exciting is just being able to show somebody, hey, this isn't magic, just send email and ask for somebody to buy something, right? And yep. just provide value, and people will reward you if you have a good product. So, you know, I spent a lot of years selling diet pills and skincare and affiliate stuff like that, and just finding somebody who has something that is tangible. And one of the things that Justin repeats is, you know, find the stream of money and put your bucket in it, right? You know, so chocolate and copper cookware, you know, it's a way easier on everybody sale than, you know, buy the skincare that's going to change you into looking like Kim Kardashian or whatever.
Yeah.
So
a couple of things I want to pull out with that, which is really interesting, I think. So one of the things is that you've started putting criteria around the people that you'll work with. So you don't want to work with startups. You want to work with real products. You want to work with two. And I think that's a really interesting mental shift that we observe in the AdSkills media buying universe. When you realize for that first time, hang on, instead of just accepting any client just to get money in, I can start to pick I specialize in e-commerce. I've done e-commerce because of my affiliate background and everything else that makes, and my service background from back, you've
right.
aggregated those experiences and skills to know, yeah, well, e-commerce is my thing. And yep. I know for e-commerce to work, my clients really need to meet these criteria.
Right.
And then you know, as you say, chocolate in Australia, right, which is awesome. You know, you certainly haven't been traveling to Australia the last right. Yeah. So you've got a global reach for, you know, it doesn't matter where you are, which is awesome. And copper pan, aren't those copper pans awesome? You know, I just, you know, you see them on the infomercials on TV.
Absolutely.
And it strikes me that, you know, if wherever you're listening to this podcast right now, if you're walking or you're in the gym or wherever you happen to be, or you're watching it in your computer, if you just look around, every one of those products is a $1 million product. And each one of those products needs a media buyer. And that's really exciting. So talk to me about the business, the chocolate business. I'm really interested in that, because how did you help them make the transition between being a, you know, three shops, having, of course, in Australia, having those shops shut down so that they literally couldn't accept customers? How did you help? What were some of the steps, some of the things you learned from bringing that traditional customer to online?
Yeah, so I, one of the things that I failed to mention is that I really like to work with a founder who is happy to get in front of the camera. So if I can coach you on how to make a video that explains the why it's, you know, the one thing that you're trying to communicate, why it's important now, busts objections, you know, gives all of the benefits of the benefits, you're going to fall in love with yourself and your family and everybody's going to be joyful and sitting around the copper, you know, the copper pot and having paella or whatever it is.
Yeah.
That ability, especially with Facebook, to create a compelling story with an offer tied to it that has a decent margin, average order value, with follow-up with email, and they have the ability to recreate that offer in a new form in every quarter, right? Meaning there's no evergreen offer on Facebook, at least as far as
I know. They all have a lifespan. Each ad has a lot, you know, ad blindness on Facebook, because that's you're targeting the same interests and areas. So, you know, we have a frequency issue at some point. You know, they see the ad too many times and they get ad blindness. So we need new creative. We need to have fresh grip. And often we can recycle it, of course. So that's really interesting. So coaching them on here's how to make it sell. So that's it. That is a very interesting thing, and something that we're really strong on in AdSkills is, of course, one of the areas you can really stand out as a media buyer is being able to help your client convert. Nothing makes them happier with you as a media buyer than sales. And
right.
You can only bring the traffic. You can bring the traffic horse to the water, but can you make it drink? Right. And that's something, by the sounds of it there, that's something that you're able to help people with. And that's a really important skill, I think.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it's, you know, to your previous point, it's easy to get clients, right? Like I got too many clients, right? It's hard to get clients that A, you want to work with, you know, you're happy to get on the phone with them once a week and discuss what it is. I mean, yeah. I don't drink, but, you know, I put the, you know, would I be happy to go and have a beer with you, right?
Yes.
And if I'm not happy to have a beer with you, I probably don't take you as a client. And, you know, are you coachable? And, you know, this chocolate client, I kept telling her, like, yeah, it's fine that your ads, top of funnel or cold ads, make money, but send email. You know, I'll send as much email for you as I can, but that's not really what you're paying me for. I want you to send email because it's going to work better if it comes from you, right? So just as an example, over the course of the last 7 days, she has couldn't believe me that was the way to go.
Yeah.
And over the last 7 days, she's sent an email every day and made $13,500 in 7 days of chocolate.
Yeah. That's a lot of chocolate.
Yeah. And I'm like, I hate to be, I told you so guy. And she's like, go ahead. So she's
that's one of the most powerful things that a media buyer has, I think, bro, is rather than, argue with the client, and this is a great Frank Kernism, actually, isn't it? Which is, hey, look, this is crazy. I know, look, this is insane, but why don't we just do a test? Why don't we just test it? Right? It probably won't work. You're probably right, but let's just do a little test. And that's one of the most powerful weapons in the media buyer's little drawer of tricks, because you don't have to have a conflict with the client, but by doing tests and experiments, let's just try something. Then they often make a discovery and learn something.
100% of the time, I always test what they think it should be.
Yes. Beautiful.
Right? So they're like, I think it should be this, this, and this. I'm like, fantastic. We'll put it in there against mine and we'll see what happens. And sometimes it works, right? Like sometimes they're better than mine, but you know, you never know what's going to work. You can have some idea, but that's why the chocolate ads work, is because she's behind the camera communicating her passion for that business and why she, you know, she tastes the chocolate on camera and tells them how it's going to feel and what she feels afterwards. And so, having clients that are happy to have a go is really the, I mean, that's.
Yeah. So that's been, really. Brian, this is fantastic. And so what about, what's ahead for you? What are you like as you look to 2021 and beyond with your business and your agency? Is there something that you're looking to focus on or concentrate going forward?
Yeah. So are you familiar with the term session players? Like
terms of like Nashville and Motown music. Go on, explain it.
Yeah. So I'm not trying to build a giant agency. I'm trying to build a little group of session players. Right. And I don't want to have to help her with chocolate forever and have to feel like she has to employ me forever. I want to get her to the point where she's so busy and happy that she's happy to pay me. And I bring in little session players to, you know, she wants a new Shopify site. I bring in my drummer to bang out the Shopify site. And then he goes away. The copper guy wants help with Amazon. I don't do Amazon. So I bring in that guy and he fixes it and then he goes away. So finding clients that I can help, I'd like to start out with like a 3 month sort of setup fee, if you will. And then after that, if they still want me, I try to move to a pay per performance model where I get paid on everything I sell. Now, obviously it's difficult because not everything tracks and that gets worse and worse over time. But, you know, generally if I can add enough value, they, you know, are happy to do that. So I like to ride bicycles. So I like to do some great work every day. And then I like to go ride bikes. So, and you know, I got a 12
probably
year old.
A few, probably a few bike manufacturers and bike parts and bike people that you could potentially target with your skills there.
Yeah, for sure. Right. They're having trouble keeping parts and bikes in stock at this point.
Yeah, that is true. The bike, you know, what COVID takes away, it also has, you know, for every business that has been horribly, and it's terrible, dramatically impacted, there's been another business that it's been like Black Friday every single day for the last 6 months. And what's all in common is that, of course, they all need media buyers, which is pretty exciting. And we're very excited with AdSkills to really focus on that performance side of the business as well. We're bringing a few people together in terms of teaching people how to do that, you know, performance-based gigs, because that's where it gets really exciting. If you can effectively become a partner in the business, you know, sort of like have equity in the business, if you will, is really exciting. Brian, thank you so much for being part of this new series. What a way to start. It's fantastic. Brian, how do people reach out to you? Either they think they might be a potential session player, or if they're listening to this as a potential client, please let us know your contact details and how do people get in touch.
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the things that I like to think about as it relates to really what some of the things that Justin really pushes is knowing that avatar, falling in love with that avatar, refreshing that avatar every 6 weeks to 6 months. And I really like the idea of making that avatar the hero of your business. And so the little agency session playing thing that I have put together is built around that concept. And it's someone rad. And someone rad is your avatar, right? So
yes,
if you're not the, most people go into business thinking that they're going to be the hero, that they're going to save everyone from their problems. And it really, the hero is, as we all know, the customer's the hero, right? It's their journey. Mm-hmm. So I like the idea of making the customer the focus of all of these things. So you can reach me at someonerad.com.
I love that. What a someonerad.com. That is an awesome URL. And if you're not watching the video, because as well as being director of marketing here at AdSkills, I am also director of fashion here at AdSkills. And I'm not sure if you're aware of that. Obviously, you probably are because of my fashion forward. But mate, your shirt is awesome. For those of you who can't see it, you're going to have a look. But that is one of the best URLs I've ever heard. I love that. Someonerad.com. Brian Pedder, thank you so much for being part of this series of AdSkills Media Buying Stories. What a great one to start off with, and can't wait to see you around the AdSkills universe.
Hey, thank you. And what all I could say is the AdSkills, from top to bottom, as far as I can tell, is exceptional. Just having a group of people who are white hat and interested in supporting other people in the industry is, having been in it so long, really, really valuable. So if you were thinking about buying any of their products, do it. It's take the leap of faith. It's entirely worth it.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Brian. Well, thank you, everybody. And we'll join you next time for our AdSkills deep dive into people in the media buying universe. Real stories, real people. Thanks very much, everybody. And we will speak soon.
If you'd like to learn more about how to use paid traffic and analytics to scale your business, subscribe to the AdSkills channel so you'll be notified every time new content is released. If you'd like to learn more about the topic we just discussed, check out the related video we're posting right now.